We frequently talk about pants on the show, speculating that our esteemed book critic in Boston may do these episodes in a pantsless state. I'm at work, so I can't do that. Why all this talk about pants? You know, if you're listening, Who Wet My Pants is our book. And I have no idea where this episode's going to go. Stay tuned. Welcome back to Book of the Day on CPL Radio and on whatever platform you're watching or listening to us on. And we're so glad you're along for the ride. I am here with Steve Donahue in Boston. I'm Jeff Messerman in Cedarburg, Wisconsin. And Steve, just spill it. What's our book today?
We didn't want to leak the contents of this episode ahead of time. This is a children's book. We like to do a kid's book on Friday. This is written by Bob Shea and illustrated by Zachariah O'Hara, and it is destined to be a classic. It is Who Wet My Pants?
I hope all of you are holding your copies up at home, too.
It's the story of a group of friends. There's a cat. There's a turtle. There's a cow. There's a lion. There's a Sasquatch. And there's a bear named Reuben.
Yes.
And he's brought donuts because they are out camping. And it's looks like it's going to be a great time.
Lovely afternoon, yes.
Until catastrophe strikes. Until Reuben realizes, see, they're all ready to have lots of fun.
And lots of donuts.
Until Reuben realizes the problem. In fact, it's pointed out to him by the raccoon who says, ahem.
Yeah, isn't that always the case? Aren't the raccoons the first to do that sort of thing? That's so
they're
classic.
Certainly the first to notice. Yes. At which point, Reuben wants to know, all right, all of you, who wet my pants?
Someone's got some splaining to do.
Yes. Reuben actually says, oh, sure, it's all chipper, cheery, chatty town when I bring donuts. But when somebody wets my pants, everybody clams up. Because no one's talking. Everyone's looking away awkwardly. Until finally, someone suggests, dude, it's no big deal. It was probably just an accident. It happens to everybody. But he's not satisfied with that. He even said,
inconceivable.
Sasquatch says to him, gosh, I used to wet my pants all the time. We all understand. And Reuben's not having any of that, as you can see. Sasquatch is big. Reuben is not having any of that. He says, oh, really? All the time, you say. Wet pants are old hat, are they? You know something, Bigfoot? I'm not even sure I believe in you. But if I did, I'd have one thing to say. Did you wet my pants?
That poor Sasquatch. I feel for him.
The interrogation goes on.
Yes.
And at one point, Reuben is driven to the height of paranoia and suggests you all. But in the process of explaining his thoughts, he explains his day before the camping trip. And one of the things he did on his day was tank up on lemonade, a huge amount of it. Look at all those empty bottles down there. Another thing he did on his day off was walk by a waterfall. All of our male listeners now are feeling the same urge. They're feeling one thing and one thing only. You ladies out there, that's exactly how suggestible this urge is. But it gets worse than that. Because at home at the end of that day, Reuben falls asleep next to his bubbling fish tank.
Well, my knee's bouncing right now, I'll tell you.
We know that the camping trip goes on and Reuben is not really satisfied. But no conclusion is drawn about those days' activities, but it makes things pretty clear. It makes the answer to the question of our time pretty clear.
You know what I love about this book is the little subtitle or header that says, it's not the crime,
it's the
cover-up.
So I laughed so hard when we learned that Reuben drank a ton of lemonade, walked by a waterfall, sat next to his fish tank. That is just so priceless.
Any kid listening to this story or reading it will immediately say, well, how could you not have wet pants?
And, you know, we're enjoying the modern Tolstoy-level classic of Who Wet My Pants just yes. for its own merits. But I want to point out about kids' books, the really good ones speak to both the kid and the adult who's going to be forced to read it over and over again.
Night after night after night.
At one point, Ruben says, I know you're all thinking about wetting my pants vis-a-vis this or that. No kid is going to know that phrase. Right. That's for the adult. Yes. Also, that hilarious sequence where he is doing all the wrong things if he wants to get his mind off wetting his pants, that also is aimed at adults.
Oh, I'm certainly. Not
sure the kid is going to put those dots together. But the part that's aimed at a kid is that Ruben's friends don't judge him. These things happen all the time. It's no big deal.
No judgment.
Yep. Right. It defangs and makes funny something that may be worrying a kid. Yeah. And that's a wonderful thing. When a kid's book can do both those things at the same time, that's wonderful.
As a kid's author, I imagine Bob Shea, who is the maestro behind this book, he must have been thunderstruck by, you know, as he's kind of swirling around trying to cobble his ideas together. And he's like, I can bring all this together in a funny way and still make kids feel good about something that would not be a positive interaction sometimes possibly with other people. So,
right.
Yeah. So
and I'm by not that, sure. I'd be willing to bet there's a chance that it came out of a comment made by a kid.
Sure.
I could easily picture a little kid saying, I don't know who did that.
Yeah. And
which would be automatically. That is your kid's book for today. It's a classic. It is
just wonderful. Oh, without it, everywhere. Very popular. A lot of kids' story times. Readily available. There's a few other Bob Shea books out there too, and they seem to. There's a unicorn one that looks like it's a unicorn who is kind of maybe a little jittery. So maybe they're going to address that a little bit. And it looks quite tongue in cheek as well. Artwork is wonderful. Everything you could want in a kid's picture book right there. So a perfect Friday book of the day. And now I'm going to go finish my coffee and keep my eyes on everybody around me. So
my age is a natural question anyway. You have a few more years to go before you start to ask it every day.
It had to have been anyone but me. So anyway, thank you so much, Steve, for a fantastic recommendation, and we will be and back next
week. Yes, we finished.
That is it. Week. It's in the books. Yes, we've been it.
Today.
There we are. Week 3.5, I think, is what we're looking at here.
Remember, it's such an endless prison sentence. My God. But we'll be back next week with a whole bunch of mix and match fun stuff.
I can't wait for the weekend when I get the preview and you all have to show up. I'm first. All right. Bye-bye, everybody.
So long. Take care.